In this video, I'm going to briefly go over how to become a supernode in the supernode proof of stake system. So as we can see here, there is 15 supernodes and a number of backup nodes. And the columns on VSIS rate contain information about the fee, which is the percentage of minting rewards taken by the supernode to maintain hardware costs. The node address, which is the wallet address of your supernode. The capacity, which is how many coins your supernode allows to gain lease rewards for leasing. This ensures that the minting rewards don't get spread too thin. The interest cycle tells us how often your supernode distributes minting rewards to leases. And the efficiency tells us what percentage of blocks assigned to your supernode was successfully minted by your supernode. And finally, the country in which your node is based. If your organization is ready to be listed as a supernode, simply scroll to the bottom of this webpage, press submit, and it will direct you to this form. Fill out this form with the details of your supernode, and if everything is fine, we will list your supernode as a backup node. So if we look back here, so your node will be listed down here. Once your information has been confirmed and everything is in place, your node should then be listed as a backup supernode. Your organization should then try and gain support from a large number of users, or alternatively gain support from investors with a large amount of coins. Once you have gained enough support in the form of a large number of leased coins to your supernode, your minting average balance will increase. The way minting average balance works is that it takes some time for incoming coins to fully be added to your MAB, but any outgoing coins instantly lowers your MAB. You can open the vSystems API by typing in your node's IP address and the port to the Swagger client. The default port is 9922. So we can look down here for details of balance. And if we put in any address, we can see here the effective balance here is your balance plus any leased coins to your address. The minting average is slightly lower as there have been coins recently leased to the wallet. It will take some time before those coins have its full effect on the wallet's MAB. Once your MAB has reached a level where you can successfully contend a supernode slot, simply contend that slot by using the API. Here's how it looks when you want to contend a supernode slot. Scroll down the API to the SPOS here, and you should see the contend API right here. So if you press here and then type in your node address, and the slot ID you would like to contend, so for example 10. An important thing to note is that the transaction fee for slot contending is quite large, and it is destroyed as soon as you send the contend transaction. This is not refundable regardless of the outcome of the contend transaction. Fill in 100 for the fee scan, and press this button to contend the slot. After becoming a supernode, it is recommended that your organization creates a website promoting your product and maintain a relationship between your organization and the system's coin holders. It is also recommended that a backup server is utilized in case one server stops operating. The efficiency of your supernode can then be maintained. For the purposes of maintaining supernode efficiency, the recommended server to run on is AWS i3 Large.